We are looking at fractions and decimals in chapter 2, division of fractions. So what do we mean when we divide fractions? Means one is fraction, say P by Q. Another is also say A by B. These are two fractions. So we are trying to divide these two fractions. Let us take an example. John has a paper strip of length 6 centimeter. This is 6 centimeter. Now, he cuts this strip in smaller strips of length 2 each. This 2, 2. How much strips he has now? 6 divided by 2. Right? Now, he does one more thing. John cuts another strip of length 6 centimeter into smaller strips of length 3 by 2 centimeter. We know that this 3 by 2 is nothing but 1.5. So, how to get this? 6 divided by 3 by 2. This will be the number of strips. How much this will be? Right? Let us take one more example. A paper strip of length say 15 by 2 can be cut into smaller strips of length say 3 by 2. Now we have to find 15 by 2 divided by 3 by 2. How to get the result of this? So let us take first example that we want to divide 1 into halves. 1 divided by half. So this is 1, this whole is 1, and we are trying to divide it into half, this half and this half. Okay, these are two halves. 1 divided by half. So this is 1 by half. 1 divided by half, that is 1 by 1 by 2, is nothing but 1 by 1, this is 1 by 1, and this is 1 by 2. So we take 2 above 2 by 1. So essentially what we are doing is, 1 divided by half is nothing but 1 into 2 by 1, reciprocal of this, right? So again, if you want to divide 3 to 1 by 4, so this is 1, this is 1, this is 1. Again, this 1 by 4, so 1 to 1 by 4, there are 3 circles. So we have to make 3 circles, 1, 2, 3, 3 circles and 1 by 4, means 4 divisions we have to make, okay? So what do we get? How many parts do we get? How many parts we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So these are 12 parts. So we are dividing 3 into 1 by 4 and we are getting 12 parts. How can we get it? 3 by 1. This divide can be changed into multiplication and just reverse it. Means take the reciprocal 4 by 1. This becomes 12. Okay, this is how we get 12. So reciprocal of a function is what? What we are trying to do here is, whenever we are dividing two fractions or whole number or a fraction with a whole number, then what we are trying to do here is, if this is 7 into 7, 1 by 7, this is equal to 7 divided by 7, reciprocal of this. Or you can say 1 by 9 divided by 1 by 9 is equal to 1 by 9 into 1 by 9, this 9. We have to take the reciprocal. Okay. So the non-zero numbers whose product with each other is 1 are called the reciprocals of each other. So 5 by 9, what we have to do is change the numerator to denominator and denominator to numerator and numerator to denominator. So P by Q should be changed to Q by P. This is the reciprocal. And when we multiply these two, we get 1. This we get 1. Okay. So how exactly you get division? So what 1 divided by 1 by 2 is essentially 1 into reciprocal of this, so 2 by 1. 3 divided by 1 by 4 is nothing but 3 into reciprocal of this, 3 into 4 by 1. This is 3 into 2 by 1. So you get 6 out of it. 2 divided by 1 by 4, so this is 2 by 1. 2 by 1 divided means into reciprocal of this, 4 by 3. Okay, so this you get 8 by 3. You got the idea? 5 divided by 2 by 9 is nothing but 5 into 9 by 2. This you get. So to divide a whole number by a fraction, we just multiply the whole number by reciprocal of that function. So 7 divided by 2 by 5 is nothing but 7 into 5 here, 2 here, 5 by 2. 6 into 7 by 4. That gives you 7, 6 is 42, 42 by 4. Here it will be 9 by 8. Right? 9 to the 18, 18 by 8. And you can easily you cancel it out, means this 2 4s are 8 and 2 9s are 18. Again, while dividing a whole number by a mixed fraction, what you do? First, you have to change this in this mixed fraction into improper fraction. So 2 by 5 is 5 to the 10, 10 to the 12, 12 by 5. 4 divided by 12 by 5 is nothing but 4 into 5 by 12. Here also 5 divided by this divided 3 1 by 3. 3 1 by 3 has to be changed into the proper this improper fraction. 3 is a 9, 9 plus 1 is 10, 10 by 3. 5 divided by 10 by 3 is nothing but 5 into 3 by 10. 5 to the 10, this gives you 3 by 2. How to divide or division of a fraction by a whole number? So the same thing will apply here. When you divide this fraction by a whole number, this 3 by 4 into, when you do into, this needs to be reciprocated or reciprocal, 1 by 3. It gives you 1 by 4. Again, take any more example. 4 into 2 by 5, this you have to first convert the mixed fraction into improper fraction. 5 4s are 20, 20 plus 2 is 22. This is 22 by 5 and this is divided by 3. Make it multiply. So when you multiply, it will be 1 by 3. So this gives you 22 by 15. How about division of a fraction by a fraction? This becomes quite easy now after understanding the previous one. 1 by 3 divided by 6 by 5 is nothing but 1 by 3 into this here, 5 by 6. This gives you 5 by 6 is 18, right? Again, 1 by 2 divided by 3 by 4 is, you have to just take the reciprocal of this. 1 by 2 into 4 by 3. 2 to the 4, this gives you 2 by 3. Take any one of these. Say this one. 5, 6 is 30. 30 plus 1 is 31 by 6 into 9 by 2. So it becomes 2 by 9. Right? So 2, 3 is 6. 9, 3 is 27. This becomes 31 by 27. Now let us talk about the decimal numbers. Here are certain examples. And if you take one of these examples, 253.147. How this has come? 253.147 has come by two. First, take the left part and then we'll take the right part. So 253, this is nothing but 2 into 100 plus 5 into 10 plus 3 into 1. So 3 is 1's, 5 is 10's place, and 2 is 100 place. And how about this? The later one, that is 0.147, this one. So this is nothing but 0.147 is 0.1 plus 0.04 plus 0.007. This is what? 1 by 10. 1 by 100. 4 by 100. This is 7 by 1000. So what you get here is, this is 1 by 10. This is 4 by 100 and this is 7 by 1000. So these are the places where you get this particular number. Take any more example, you will get these decimal numbers. So when you take this, this is the 1, 1's and then 100, 10, 100, then 1 by 10, 1 by 100 and 1 by 1000. Now let us take one more example. John has 15.50. and Salma has 15.75. How to find out which one of these is greater? So we start with the first one. 1 is equal to 1, then 5 is equal to 5, then we go to the values which are on the right hand side of the decimal. 5 is equal to 7, no, 7 is greater, so this becomes greater. 5 is less than 7, so this is less than this one. Okay. Now you can quickly find out the comparison between any of these. Let us take this example. 1 is less than 2, so this is greater. This is greater. 2 is equal to 2, 0 is equal to 0, and then after decimal, 1 is greater than 0, so this becomes 0, or this becomes greater. So we have to convert many a times one value to another. Why? Because we have to always make decimals when we have to compare or convert the unit, the value into the higher units. For example, 3 paisa. 3 paisa is 3 by 100 rupees because 1 paisa or say 100 paisa is equal to 1 rupees. Similarly, 1000 gram is equal to 1 kg. Similarly, 100 centimeter is equal to 1 meter. So you can just convert it. 75 paisa means 75 by 100 rupees. 250 gram means 250 by 1000 kg. 85 centimeter means 85 by 100 meter. When you add these two, or when you want to add values, you just have to see that the decimal values remain just over one another. Then you can just add the way you want, like the way you generally add values, like 6 and 5 is 11, one carry. This is 7, 10 plus 1 is 8, and 3 plus 2 is 5. Similarly, if you want to subtract, same thing will be done. You just have to place this decimal one over another, 29.35 minus 0.04.56, 15 minus 6 is 9, 13 minus 5 is 7, and this becomes 12 actually, 12 minus 7 is 5 is 7, then again this 8 minus 4 is 4 and 2 minus 0 is 2. Now multiplication of decimal numbers, when you multiply decimal numbers, there are certain ways. First, let us take example. Reshma purchased 1.5 kg vegetable at a rate of 8.50 per kg. So what you have to do is 8.5 into 1.5. So there are two methods. First method is you can directly multiply and then you find out how many decimal points are there or how many numbers are after decimal points. So let us take a simple example. 0.1 into 0.1. 0.1 means 1 by 10. So this becomes 1 by 10 into 1 by 10. We know that numerator, denominator multiplication, this is 1 by 100. And 1 by 100 is what? How many zeros are there? 2. So just take one value, then again second value, so you have to put a 0 and then place a decimal. So after decimal, there should be two values because there are two zeros. There is another method. 0.1 into 0.1. What this becomes? 1 only. You just forget about these decimals. 1 into 1 is 1 and then put the decimal value because there are two values after decimal. So you have to place 1, then 0.101. So this is 1 by 10 into 1 by 10 is nothing but you have this one area. You have divided into 10 places. Then again you have divided, this is 1 by 10. Then you are dividing the 1 by 10th one again 1 by 10th one. 1 by 10th of 1 by 10th is this part, single part. Okay. So this is how you get 1 by 10th of the 1 by 10th part. And I can take one more example, 0.2 into 0.3. 0.2 can be written as 2 by 10. 0.3 can be written as 3 by 10. This will be equal to 6 by 100. And because there are two zeros, one value here, one value here, then point. Then this is nothing but, you know, you can just have a look that what we are doing here is we are trying to take a fraction or fractional value of a fraction. So for that you have to have some decimal values. When you multiply two values, when you count the number of digits starting from the rightmost digit and move towards left, so we have to put the decimal points there. Where is this is shifting? Let us see. 1.2 into 2.5. So this gives you what? The value is nothing but 300. 12 into 25. Just take 12 into 25. Then there are two decimals. So you have to take these 300. Take two decimals. One point here, one point here. These two values are there after decimal. Then you put point here. So this becomes 3. How about this? How about this? Exactly same. So let us take one more example. Like here you have to multiply 2.5 by 1.25. So you just multiply 25 by 125. You get certain value, say 3225. Now where to place the decimal? Because two values are after decimal and this is one value, so there are three values after decimal. So 1, 2, 3, here place the decimal. Okay, this is how you get. The sides of an equilateral triangle is 3.5 centimeter. Find its perimeter. This is a triangle. The side of triangle is 3.5. and perimeter is, we have to find out the perimeter. So you, these equilateral has all sides equal. So 3.5 into 3 gives you the value. 3 into 3.5, just multiply 3 by 35. This gives you 105. And we have just one decimal, one value after decimal, you can place just 10.5. The length of the rectangle is 7.1 centimeter, breadth is 2.5 centimeter. Area is length into breadth. So 7.1 into 2.5, you just multiply. You get in square units, 71 into 25 is 1775. Because there are two values after decimal, 1, 2. So you have to place a decimal here. When you multiply the decimal number by say 10, 100 and 1000. So when you multiply 10, 100 or 1000, so the values, they are shifted. And shifted not on the previous discussion we had. Now we have to shift it on the other side. That is, this is 1.76 into 10. When you are multiplying by 10, this is nothing but 176 by 100. So when you multiply by 10, you have to place it decimal here. So when you multiply by 10, you have to shift the decimal on the right. When you multiply 2.35 by 10, you just shift the decimal here, 23.5 will be the answer. When you multiply by 1000, you have to shift 3, decimal 3 point. 1, 2 and 3. So this will be 1, 2, 3, 5, 6. Okay. 0.5 into 1000. So this is 0.5. 0.5 is nothing but 0.5, 0, 0, 0. You can write any zeros. So three zeros are there. So you have to place it here, here, here. So this becomes 500. So whenever you are multiplying by 10, 100 or 1000 or any number of zeros, you have to just shift the decimal on the right. You have to just shift the decimal one for one zero at one point. Okay. So when a decimal number is multiplied by 10, 100, 1000, the digit in the product are same in the decimal numbers, but the decimal point in the product is shifted on the right as many of places as there are zeros over one. So you can take one more example like 56.3 into 1000. So 56.3 you can write 56.3000, any zeros you can take. So when you multiply by 1000, this is 1130. So we have to shift 3. So this becomes 56300. Division of decimal numbers. So when you want to divide the decimal number, then what you have to do? There are certain methods. First is 9.5 by 1.9, say. So what you have to do? 9.5 can be written as, this is basically 9.5 divided by 1.9. 9.5 can be written as 95 by 10. And this can be written as into. And this is can be written as 19 by 10. So reciprocal of this is 10 by 19. This gets cancelled out. This becomes 95 by 19. Okay. So you just have to divide 95 by 19. So when you divide 95 by 19, whatever result will come, but this decimal will be gone. So what we are doing here is, when we are dividing the value with 10, we have to shift the decimal to one place on the left. So 31.5 divided by 10 will make it 3.15, right? So 31.5 is nothing but 31 by 5 by 10, and this makes into, so you have to take 1 by 10, so this becomes 100. So you have to shift. 100 means you have to place it here, 1, 2, 2 zeros, so 3.15. Similarly, when you divide it by 100, so 31.5 divided by 100 means two shifting has to be done. One here, one, then two. So this becomes 0.315. So this is how you do it. Just take one more example, 29.36 divided by 1000. 29.36 divided by 1000. So you have to shift it three decimals. So 1, 2, because there is nothing, so you have to place a 0.02936. This value will be like this. So the shifting, when you divide a number by 10, 100 or 1000, the digit of the number and the quotient are the same. But the decimal point in the quotient shifts to the left, as I just suggested. As many places are there, they are zeros over one. a division of a decimal number by a whole number. So when you divide 6.4 by 2, what you do? The best way is to put it like this. 6.4 is 64 by 10. Make it into, so this will be 1 by 2. This become 32. 32 by 10 is 3.2. This is one way. There are other ways also. For example, if you want to divide 82.44 divided by 6, what you have to do? 82.44 divided by 6. This you can do. And because we have this point, there are two zeros also. So you can place this zero later on and just divide 82.44 by 6. Then we can place the zeros or place the decimal. When you divide 12.96 by 4, so 12.96 is 1296 by 100. Divided by 4, multiplied, it becomes 1 by 4, right? So this is 1296 by 400. But you just keep this 100 away, divide this, this becomes 324. Now you have 100, so this becomes 1 place, 2nd place. So 3.24 will be the answer. Let us take one more example, that the average of these three numbers we have to find out. So we just have to add 4.2 with 3.8 and 7.6, this gives you this. And when you divide it by 3, you get 5.2. When you divide a decimal number by another decimal number, so this is quite easy, because what we have known is, if the decimal points are equal, means 25.5, after decimal there is one number, after decimal there is one number. So you just cancel out that number. Okay, so because 25.5 is nothing but 255 by 10, and this 0.5 is 5 by 10. When you take it up, this will be 10 by 5. So this eventually gets cancelled out. Okay. So you just get 255 by 5 by 5. That is 51. Then 222.5 by 1.5 again. Point because both decimal has one digit on the right hand side. You just cancel it out. 225 by 15. That gives you 15. Now at this point, this kind of example, what you see? Here we have three values of the after decimal. 1, 2, 3. Here you have two values after decimal. So two values and two values will get cancelled out. So now one value will remain, because 3725 by 1000, this is this one, and this is 25 by 100. Take 100 here, 25. So this is 33725, means this is again 10. So this is 3372.5 by 25. What you can do here is 33725 divided by 25. Then you can place a point. So this gives you 134.9. And how about this number? You don't have any number here. And this is 0.03. So this is nothing but you have this 3 by 100. Take 100 above. 2700 by 3. This gives you 900. Each side of a regular polygon is 2.5 centimeter in length. So we have regular polygon, the perimeter of the polygon is 12.5. So 2.5 into x is equal to 12.5. So when you have to find the sides, you just have to divide 12.5 by 2.5. So 12.5 by 2.5 is, you just eliminate this decimal, because these are eventually going to be cancelled. You just divide 125 by 25, you get 5. How about a car? Car covers a distance of 89.1 km in 2.2 hours. What is the average distance? So the distance covered in 1 hour. So we have to find out 89.1 by 2.2, because the distance covered in 1 hour is nothing but 89.1 by 2.2. Because decimal are equivalent, both decimals have one value, which is after it. So 891 by 22, that gives you 40.5. So what we have discussed in chapter, we have learned about the fractions and decimal. We have seen the addition and subtraction also. Then we saw the multiplication, division on fractions. We saw that when we multiply two fractions, we have to multiply the product of the numerators has to be done, and product of denominators has to be done. The fraction act as an operator of off. So you just have to multiply. Half of 2 is half of 2, that is half into 1. The product of two proper fractions is less than each of the fractions which are multiplied. The product of proper and improper fraction is less than the improper fraction and greater than the proper fraction. And the product of two improper fractions is greater than the two fractions. The reciprocal is numerator to denominator, denominator to numerator. We also seen how to divide two fractions, means 2 divided by 3 by 5 is nothing but 2 into 5 by 3, like this. 2 by 3 divided by 7 is This is 7 by 1, so 2 into 1 by 7. 2 by 3 divided by 5 by 7 is 2 by 3 into 7 by 5. So this is what you get. When you multiply the decimal numbers, so you just have to see how many values are there after the decimal. So you just have to place that decimal after those numbers. So the value is 35, so you have to place it here. When you multiply a decimal number by 10, 100 or 1000 or any zeros value, you have to shift that decimal on the right. When you divide a decimal number by a whole number, so what you have to do, you just keep it like 84 by 4 and then place the value. When you divide a decimal number by 10, 100 or 1000, you have to shift the decimal values on the left, right? Like this, if you are dividing, just divide 24 by 2, then place, this gets cancelled out because they are equivalent decimals. So this is about the fraction and decimal of this chapter. Thank you so much. Take care of yourself.